What's up, guys? It's Ryantium here, and today we are back in Skyrim, and oh snap, it's gonna be an awesome freaking day. But first, if you guys enjoy what you're about to see, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe for more daily videos. And if you haven't done already, follow me on Twitter. Link is down there in the description. So, guys, welcome back, and happy Sunday, everybody. So, today we are here in the lovely and wonderful, beautiful Whiterun, but we're not gonna be in Whiterun today because, guys, we're gonna be inside this thing. So what the hell am I talking about? Well, the Staff of Shalador is a small house on the tip of the Staff of Shalador. So once you load into the game with this mod installed, the Staff of Shalador will be equipped or will be added to your inventory. And it's crazy, guys. I love little homes like this, but what makes this very cool, guys, is I've done mods from this mod author in the past, and this is by the same people who did Snippy, they did the White River House, and they did Telemos, and I'm sure there's plenty more that I have not seen, but I love these guys, you know, they're so great at what they do, their mods are wonderful, and without further ado, let's just go ahead and get into this, guys, because I haven't seen it, and I really want to see what this looks like. So, you can either equip it, or inside of your inventory, unequip it, go to equip, and move into the staff. Oh my gosh, this is so freaking cool, dude. Are you serious? Look at that. Everything is upside down. I freaking love that. Okay, let's go ahead and turn the heads-up display back on so we can see if there's any buttons or anything like that, or just crazy like that. There's the pedestal of return. That's how I assume you get back outside. But let's see, what do we got inside of here? First off, can we just go ahead and admire the fact that your outside window is showing you those rings that were rotating around the top of the staff? How freaking cool is that? Now let's see, oh, don't you tell me this is how you get to your bed. Oh, it is. Oh my freaking god, you gotta be kidding me. That is so freaking unique, dude. So you walk into this to go from on your ceiling to on the ground and vice versa. So your ceiling becomes your ground and your ground becomes your ceiling, which I think is super freaking cool. Now let's see, open Staff of Shalador. We'll come back in and check out the rest of it. Oh no freaking way. There's more stuff. Okay, now I'm on the side of it. Wait a second, this is tripping me out, dude. Let's see, there's water right here. Is this supposed to be your shower? Your sideways facing shower? That is insanity, dude. So let's see, we got some weapon racks right here, weapon plaques, which is very nice. Over here, you have an extra anvil. Very, very cool. Now let's see, what do we got right here? That is trippy as shit, dude. Oh my god, my brain hurts. Now let's see, you got a barrel for some storage? Very, very nice. A bookshelf? Go ahead and store your books inside of it. Now let's see, what goes right here? Got a cupboard, some Sir Lyle wine. Very, very nice. Oh god, that just disoriented the shit out of me. Got a grindstone right there. Large sacks for storage. Got another shelf for books and stuff like that. Workbench, some candles. More storage, got a tanning rack. So you've got your workbench, you've got your tanning rack, and you've also got your anvil. Holy hell, that's cool. But I don't see a smeltery, but I can't really imagine it being too big of a problem, not having a smeltery, we're literally inside of a staff. You can take your house with you, and you can stand right next to your smeltery and be good to go. Holy cow, this is crazy. Got a chest right here for storage. I love this water feature right here. It's just so nifty. Alright, now let's check out the main part of the staff. Oh my gosh, I can't get over the fact that we're literally inside of the staff. So lots and lots of areas for storage. You have an arcane enchanter, you got some neat little plants right here, a bed. Nothing too fancy, nothing too crazy. And you know, I think it's funny, in one of my last mod showcases, I had said something about loving smaller homes and seeing what the mod author slash mod authors can fit into such tiny spaces, and I'm pretty sure this is probably the smallest space I've seen a full house fit into, which is super cool. So let's see, you got a strong box right here, bookshelf for more storage, lots and lots of static decor, which I'm such a huge fan of, dude. Let's see, we got some staves right here, safe for all your good stuff, and armor mannequin. Very, very nice. And I love the colors, dude, the blues and the greens and the oranges and the reds and all that stuff is just gorgeous. Oh, there's the water. Oh my god, it's watering your plant. Holy shit, that's cool. Now up here, you got yourself an alchemy lab. Lots and lots of storage for all your stuff. You got a statue of Dibella. Lots and lots of storage. You got a cooking pot. That's good to know. Search chest. Another armor mannequin right here. Very, very nice. And then this is the return pedestal, I believe. Okay, yep, that is amazing. That is freaking incredible. You've got to be kidding me. And if you equip it just regularly, I was testing this out earlier, it shoots freaking lightning, dude. How much cooler could a house get? You could literally kill someone with your damn house. So, guys, very, very short mod showcase for today, but I had to do it, you know? This is such a cool mod, it's such a unique mod, and I've done mod showcases like this before, like the Inkwell Home. The Inkwell Home is another good example of how much freaking mod authors can pack into one little place, and I gotta say, this one is definitely on top of my list for being one of my favorite mobile player homes. So guys, if you're a fan of mobile player homes, or you're a fan of custom player homes, I would highly suggest downloading this mod. Are you kidding me? It's such a unique mod. So freaking cool. So, guys, I hope you guys enjoyed today's little mod showcase. And if you did, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe for more daily videos. And if you haven't done already, follow me on Twitter. And guys, I will see you in the next video.